patient. We had just a little technical difficulties to start there. We have so much going on in this panel. It's hard for all the technology to handle it, I guess. But let's give a big round of applause to our Javits Center staff. So yeah, we're getting just a little bit of a late start, but we are gonna make up for it. We have so much excitement. So welcome, guys. You guys are at the Anime NYC Sailor Moon panel. This is the very first Anime NYC, and we are so excited to bring the Moon panel here. So if you're following on social media, use hashtag Moon panel, and if you want to follow the official North American Sailor Moon Twitter account, is Sailor Moon NA. So make sure you follow us so we can give you all the hearts on the internet. So today at this panel, we are gonna celebrate magic, positivity, love, and justice with our biggest moon panel yet. So let's do a few brief introductions. First of all, I'll introduce myself. My name is Charlene Ingram. I am the Director of Animation Marketing for Viz Media. And one of the titles I am so honored to work on is Sailor Moon. Thank you. Thank you. I love it. Aw, I love you guys too. I tried to be a little subdued today. Is it okay? I'm a little underdressed. Just a little bit. And I will be your MC on this magical journey. But, like a good sailor guardian, we can't do it alone. We have several helpers. We have David. Stand up, David. David on the animation marketing team, he has all the prizes because we have the most epic moon panel prizes yet. These things are insane. We also have on our social media team, we have Sailor Lawrence in the crown. So look out for the crown because he can make you famous on the internet. So, we also have, joining us, we have our cosplay helpers from American Cosplay Paradise. They're gonna be helping with lots and lots of cool things. So, you know what, let's get started with something a little extra fanciful. Now, has anyone been to a moon panel before? So you know we have a tradition that we start with. We do a sing-along, right? Well, because we're at Anime NYC, and we're just gonna be very, very extra, we have someone very special to help us with the sing-along today. This is a super big surprise, and I told you this was going to be huge. We have a special, special, special performance. Get ready to just fangirl, fanboy out. We have Miss Yoko Ishida here. She's here to sing two songs thanks to Anime Diva Night. So let's give a big round of applause to Miss Yoko Ishida.
いつか本当に出会う大事な人の To be here. See you next time, New York. Enjoy the rest of the show.
ありがとうございました。バイバイ。
Be magical. Wow, wasn't she amazing? I'm so glittery on the inside. Well, before we get back to, we have more stuff planned for our panel, but something later we wanted to share with you. There is a fan cosplay gathering today at 4:30. It is in the photographer tunnel near the Crystal Palace entrance, but if it's a little too cold there, the alternate location is just in the Crystal Palace area. So if you're a big Sailor Moon fan, if you have your Sailor Moon cosplay, you want to be a part of that photo shoot, it is a fan gathering. So go on down there and enjoy it. So before we bring up our guests, you know, we have our tech crew come up bringing up the chairs. Give it a hand for Stage Ninjas. Stage Ninjas. Take a moment to talk about a few things that happen to be available now. First up, the Sailor Moon R movie, where you can hear Yoko Ishida sing Otome no Policy. That is available now on a DVD Blu-ray combo pack, and it comes with tons of extras, and for the first time, the short makeup Sailor Guardians. We also have in a Sailor Moon 90s anime, we have season one of Sailor Moon, where the Sailor Guardians fight Queen Beryl. And back to Sailor Moon R, at Otome no Policy, we have Sailor Moon R, where a mysterious young one shows up. And who doesn't love more Sailor Guardians? Sailor Moon S! This is also available now, so get your Moon collection going. Also, very special here, just for Anime NYC, has anyone been to the Kinokuniya booth yet? Yay! Well, in partnership with Viz Media, they have a little Sailor Moon boutique, and you can get our exclusive event t-shirts. They're only $15. There's ladies in unisex sizes, small through 2XL, and they are so glittery. I mean, they're glittery, they have Pegasus on it, it's amazing, they're so soft, it's like wearing a hug. So make sure you come home with a beautiful memory of Sailor Moon Day. Now, you see, we have a lot of chairs here. A lot of chairs here. And before we're gonna bring out our voice actors, they told me they were only going to come out here if you guys were super hyped and super excited. So, no pressure. So, where is Sailor Lawrence? Where is he? There. There's the man with the crown. So we're going to welcome our voice actors with another Moon Panel tradition. Remember our More Glitter chant? Yeah. We're going to do the More Glitter chant, but we're going to do it so loud, we want everybody in the hallway to hear. Yes, it's going to be awesome. So I'm going to count down 3, 2, 1, and everybody yell in the most glittery way possible, more glitter, more glitter, more glitter. Can you guys handle it? It's a lot of pressure. It's a pretty tough script, but I trust you guys. So it'll be 3, 2, 1, more glitter. All right, let's do this. Right. Hey, 3, 2, 1, more glitter! More glitter! More glitter! More glitter! Woo! Yay! Yay, you guys did great! Oh, yes, more glitter. All right, now, I think you guys are ready. We have some very, very special guests. This is the largest gathering of Sailor Moon English voice actors ever in one place. So we have 11 members of the cast. So we're going to bring them up one by one. I want you to give them the biggest Moon Panel welcome. We're gonna start with, let's get our sparkly heart up here. Come on, glitter heart. Can you tell I like glitter in keynote? Can you tell it's my thing? All right, so come on, transition. Let's do this. I know I got some outer guardians waiting in the wings. We don't want to make them angry. First up, we have a Sailor Saturn, Miss Christine Marie Cabanos. To the end. Yeah, please. Yay! Sailor Saturn! Next up we have the Guardian of the Seas, Sailor Neptune, Lauren Landa! Come on, Neptune! Big, big welcome! And we can't have Neptune without her partner. We have Sailor Uranus. Miss Erica Mendez. Come up, Erica, welcome. All right. Next up, we're taking a quick break. There's another technical thing. So you just get to enjoy the company of the Outer Guardians while we wait for that to get fixed. Get up. Yes. I hit play. Is it back on top? No worries. It's Erica Mendez forever. And then you're going to go go back to fixing the resolution. So next up, we have, as Orange has said, we have Cherami Leigh. Yeah, okay. All right, we're gonna keep bringing the cast members out. Sorry about that. Max are a little fickle. All right, next up, we have the Guardian of Lightning, Sailor Jupiter. In the teal hair.
Hey girl, hey!
Next up, we're getting fiery with Cristina V, Sailor Mars.
This is not gonna stay in my lap.
Looking beautiful in red. Time since Anime Expo 2014, the rarest guardian of them all, we have Kate Higgins, voice of Sailor Mercury! Welcome, welcome, welcome to New York! I'll come through this way.
I'm doing pretty good.
We're missing just a couple more very important people. Now we have Chibi Moon, Sandy Fox! She's Chibi Moon after all. And joining her, this is a very special guest, one of our newest cast members. We have Pegasus, also known as Helios, Mr. Chris Niosi. With a lovely look-alike. All right, and we have more lovely gentlemen joining us. We have Tuxedo Mask himself, Mr. Robbie, Daymond!
Hello, everyone!
And finally, we have herself, Sailor Moon! Have a seat for me this time.
Oh, I'm really, gonna like, you really earned it after all this time.
Just for a bit. I can't help but get up and like walk and run around. So, all right. So before we get started with our question time, I want to tell you guys they have an autograph session today at 2:00 in the autograph area. It's just straight out that way. So it's Sailor Moon items only. But everybody got their poster as they came in, right? Well, that's not all you're going to get today. And I'll tell you about that later, but bring your poster. This session is Sailor Moon items only, and you will have your items signed by this entire cast. So that's at 2:00. So let's get started with our cast questions. Come on, glitter time. Da-da-da-da. You look beautiful!
Thank you.
Yeah.
I try.
All right. So our first question is, first of all, welcome to Sailor Moon Day. Is everyone excited?
Gosh.
Yes.
Woo! All right, now, since this is such a special occasion, and we have Kate here. So it's been a while. So how have things...
I'm in the hot seat.
You're so beautiful. So how have things been for you since your first Sailor Moon Day back at Anime Expo?
Wait, I'm sorry. I was stuck on "you're so beautiful." Say that again. I didn't hear you. What was the question?
Yeah. How have things been for you since your first Sailor Moon Day?
Personally? Or
this is a safe space.
This is a very loaded question. Is this just like a "how are things going"?
Yeah.
Okay. Gosh, when was the first Sailor Moon?
2014?
Yeah, day? AX 2014.
Wow. Okay.
I was in the audience of that one.
Yeah.
Aww.
Life has been great because I'm Sailor Mercury. How about that? And the two, and I don't really go to many cons, but the last con I went to was the Sailor Moon con in Florida this past summer. And that was very fun. I went with some of these ladies. So, sure, life's great. Yeah. I'm going to leave it at that.
You're always so cool. Well, okay, you're off the hook for now. We're gonna turn the tables on Chris.
Oh my gosh, okay, all right.
So you're our newest cast member. So What's it like to be a part of the cast of Sailor Moon?
Incredible and intimidating, and incredibly intimidating. we've been recording some stuff on Supers as of late, and I feel like now I'm finally like settling into the character after a while. I'll be perfectly honest, I was very nervous doing this show. This is a huge legacy to live up to, and Pegasus is such an important character for this season, and I never even thought I would have like a shot at playing a character like this. I feel like now I'm much more comfortable. I've been watching Super S in Japanese, actually, for the first time in Japanese ever, to see, remind myself what's going on, because it's been a long time. And I'm like, oh, there's a lot in store for me. not to give too much away if you guys haven't seen Supers before. But it's amazing, and I can't believe I was just joking. I was in the audience of the first Sailor Moon Day panel at AX 2014, and now I'm up here with you guys. What happened? How? What?
I remember you texted me,
yeah.
And I hadn't told anybody yet, and you were like, hey, are you around today for Sailor Moon Day? And
yeah.
I was backstage, and I was like, yeah, I'll be around.
Yeah. And then you walk up, and I'm like, you?
I think SOB was your response. Yeah.
And although it was you really pulled the wool over my eyes. It was beautiful.
He's a sneaky one. Before we get to our next question, tech crew, is it possible to put the screen on the confidence monitors? So our cast can read our questions. If not, that's cool. I can just talk loudly. All right. So I do. I'm good at being loud. What can I say? So this is actually for everyone. This next question: do you have any? You know, again, as Chris is on the spot.
Oh.
Do you have any words of advice for our new cast member, Chris, in his big role as Pegasus?
Find the strongest member and beat them up to establish. You establish dominance.
I have a question for Chris.
It's Amanda.
So,
Amanda.
Seeing as how Pegasus has a horn, isn't he technically a unicorn?
No, they're
an alicorn.
If
we want to go by MLP rules, yeah. I mean, look, let's get technical. By the way, for the record, I ordered a golden unicorn horn, like, headband to wear, and I didn't show up in time before I left on my flight, because I was going to show up and be like, don't tell anybody.
You know what you got to do now? You got to do a photo shoot, like the pink unicorn guy.
Like, that's, hey, everybody.
Yes, but with the gold unicorn.
Don't tell anybody I have the golden crystal. They're not going to find it.
Yeah, so, that's why the package didn't arrive. The dead moon got
it. It's just sitting at my home now, and I'm like, but anyway.
Don't mess this up, Chris. All of our dreams are counting on you.
Yeah, no pressure.
We're going to do a nighttime talk show, Talks with Chibi and Pegasus.
Yes. I would love that.
Intimate talks.
I've learned, the advice I've learned is just listen to Susie. Do everything Susie. Susie's our wonderful ADR director who's been doing the show since then, and she's the coolest person on earth. So
she's
I just
the coolest
like, yeah.
person on earth.
Wait, listen and to listen to me.
Yes, that's true. And Stephanie.
It's generally a good idea to listen to Sailor Moon. Well, you are in good hands with such a wonderful, beautiful cast, and we're so happy to have you all here. And we're so happy to welcome you to the herd, as it will.
Sorry, my voice is a little hoarse, excuse me.
So before we get back to the questions, we're going to talk about a few really cool things that are available now from our friends at Bluefin. They have a booth over in the dealer's room, and they shared lots of Sailor Moon treats with us. So we have some new figures. This is the Figure Arts Super Sailor Moon. This is out now. And we also have coming, these are the Figure Arts for, Mercury, Mars, and Jupiter is actually coming in December. So if you want to celebrate Jupiter's birthday in December, you can
Will it be out by December 5th?
It might be.
Because that's her birthday.
Yes.
So it can happen.
Aunt Amanda knows all of her characters' birthdays. We also have, and these are super gorgeous, these are the Figure Arts Zero, Chibiusa, Pegasus, and Serenity figures. These are available at the Bluefin booth. And some of these things that we are talking about today are in our prize bags for trivia. Yeah. We also have, we can't leave the Outer Guardians behind, we have a Pluto and Saturn figures. They are both available now, and these are gorgeous and have like metallics on the skirts. They're so beautiful.
Christine's like, finally!
It's like, finally I get a figure. Well, it's that whole like bringing the apocalypse thing. You know, they make sure they get it extra right. They don't want to anger Saturn. And for those of you who love Sailor Moon S, this is the Tuxedo Mirage music box that plays the song from the ending theme. And it is just, oh, it's gorgeous. I got one. I play it, my cat loves it. And it has two sets of cards, so you can do two different ways for the music box as it, the light spins inside as it plays Tuxedo Mirage. Yeah. But, so anybody in here love cosplay? So, you know how hard it is to get a perfect cosplay prop? Well, Bluefin's got you covered with the Proplica series. These are 1/1 scale props from Sailor Moon. So this is the cutie moon wand. We also have the Cosmic Heart Compact. And when you press it, it even plays the transformation music. It's really cool. Yeah, and it's so glittery. Yeah, it's really loud. So if you're cosplaying and you hit it, it's just gonna make a lot of noise. So be careful. Not that I have experience with that. We also have the Spiral Heart Moonrod. When you have a really powerful voice and you take like, what is it, like 45 seconds to a moon spiral heart attack?
Especially the heart part of heart attack.
Yeah, she is a vocal Viking. And we're not leaving Chibi Moon out. This is actually coming in January. It's Chibi Moon's Pink Moon Stick. And yeah, so you can do Pink Sugar Heart Attack. And when you're in a situation where you need some crisis makeup, we have the Rainbow Moon Chalice, and that is out now. This is really, so in my area at Viz, we have one near our inbox, and we keep candy in it. Because sometimes you just need a little pick-me-up. And finally, now we have one of these to give away today. We have the Kaleido Moonscope. Nice. So, themed for supers. Which we might talk a little bit about supers today. Who knows? So with that, where is David? Because it is about that time. We're gonna do our first prize break. Now, to help David, I need to borrow two microphones.
Here's one.
This one.
Sorry,
it's fine. Oh, the sweaty is good. We will bring them back. With so many people on stage, we can only handle so many microphones. So if you would like to play our trivia, raise your hand.
One of you
want to
go to the other side.
Yeah. And one of our lovely cosplay helpers will come to you because we have a few categories that you can choose from. So cosplay, so we have Chibi Moon, we have Helios, we have Tuxedo Mask, we have Super Sailor Moon. Oh, cats are later. Yeah. So we have our three categories. So, David, pick our first player. Hello there.
Hi.
So, which category would you like to play?
Characters, please.
Characters. Ooh, okay. So your question is, Name the sailor guardian of fire.
Sailor Mars.
Sailor Mars, yes! You get the gift bag. All right, raise your hand. Who's next? Who's next? Find a winner, find a winner.
Right here. Move, right here, right here. I got you.
All right, so would you like to pick
characters?
No, you can pick from attacks or items. Characters were taken.
Attacks.
Attacks. All right.
Wait, I can make it work.
So this one, you're going to need stand up.
Come on, call me.
You are on stage, Sailor Moon. Perform your favorite attack from Sailor Moon.
Moon Spiral Heart Attack.
Yes, Moon Spiral Heart Attack. Yes. All right, we got our last one for this prize break. Where are we going? David's got the majestic Pegasus with him. Oh, over here. Oh, Chibi Moon's got it. Can one of you impress Chibi Moon? Yeah. Find your destiny, Chibi Moon.
That's gonna be this question.
Hello, and oh, beautiful Venus cosplay.
Thank you.
Yay. So your category is items. Ooh. Items.
Okay.
Can you name one of Sailor Moon's transformation items? One of her
moon chalice?
Yes, Rainbow Moon Chalice. Yes, woo! She uses it to transform into Super Sailor Moon. Congratulations. Give them a big round of applause. Break later, including one super uber prize that will be for Nightmare Mode. So with that, we're going to go back to the cast questions. Now, as Chris mentioned earlier, the cast just started recording supers. So you guys have just recently been working on the show. Can you talk about one of your favorite scenes from this latest season you've been recording? Stephanie is like Googling. Oh.
No, I'm not Googling. So what I started doing, because you always ask this question, and I always forget. Like, as I'm recording, I'm like, oh, that part's funny. And then I like forget, right? So I started taking notes in my phone anytime I had a scene that I liked. And my favorite from Supers is episode 33. And see, it's very specific notes.
I love that you studied.
Yes, and then, and it's when, it's when the girls come and it's like they desecrate a church and they say, how dare you desecrate every girl's dream wedding location? And then Mars goes, well, maybe not mine, but still.
Oh my God, yes. Everything I've heard in Super so far is just golden. It's so good.
I think and I'm not sure if it's from this, but it's very recent, so I don't know if it's in the right art, but it's the feline infidelity episode.
Yes.
Where,
yes.
They think they're cheating, but it's like with a human nun. It's very confusing. And that's why I liked it, because like he becomes like gossipy Tuxedo Mask. Like, he wants to defend Artemis, but he's also like, tell me what happened. That was like my favorite bit from that.
We had a interesting scene where Pegasus decides to start opening up a little bit, and he speaks with Chibiusa through the little decoration that she has in her room, and completely innocently, completely not even thinking about it, she's like, oh, hold on, I gotta change for bed. So the clothes come off, and he's like, and she's, again, completely innocently, she's like, what? He's like, nothing, sorry, you know, and I'm like, all right, I know a lot of people have the obvious jokes about their relationship. I actually think that Pegasus and Chibiusa are very, very sweet and adorable, and I love their relationship. And in watching Supers in Japanese and seeing like a lot of where this arc is going, what I have to look forward to, I'm excited about what we have coming up. So a lot of cuteness.
So cute.
That's funny, I was gonna say that exact same scene, because it was like,
sorry.
I'm taking off my shirt right now. But I've been having really a lot of fun with this this whole arc and season. And I love when Sailor Moon and Chibi we're like in the scene with clowns and balls and we're like doing all, I don't know what scene that is exactly. But yeah, it was like mayhem. That was really fun. And I'm trying to think what else. I just have fun. The clowns. The crazy clowns with the weird music. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I kind of feel like they're going to give me nightmares. I don't like those clowns.
They all float, Chibius.
There's always like French kind of music, like Parisian music behind them. Yeah, they're really freaky. Oh, I'm sorry, were you done?
You sure?
Yeah. Guys, I'm really sorry, but my brain is just like, things just go right through it.
No, it's not okay. It's really
blame
not.
It on the clowns.
I'm so embarrassed. Oh,
this is why I had to take notes.
I know that I do.
We're all
have
stealing
to,
that idea I, now.
No, I'm not stealing anything. I know Mercury is really smart. Yep. And I continue to be smart. And I was just reminded that I do have my new attack. However, I thought I was saying this attack a lot. My Shine Aqua Illusion attack. But yeah, and I think the day I had to record that, because what happens is we go in there and we record our attacks, and then they keep it, so we don't have to keep yelling it over and over. But I was not in good voice that day. That's what we say, good voice. And it just wasn't coming out well, so I had to do it about 1,000 times. And I don't like the clowns. And I yell that a lot. I don't like the clowns, and I'm smart. Okay.
I like that there's an entire episode dedicated to Ray walking in on Mamoru in the shower. There was a lot of character development in that episode.
One of my favorites was the episode where Jupiter was at the, I don't know which dance it was. It was just like a dance because they have balls just around town, I guess. And especially because part of it was also like, I was that awkward kid in fourth grade who was like 5'5", so I was like awkwardly tall and boys didn't want to dance with me. So I shut up. So I don't want your pity. So there's a lot of like, oh, I relate, being the awkward tall girl. But then I love the scene where I guess the guy stands her up and then Mercury's like, I'll dance with you. And it's just like two friends, like it's really like girl power.
I'm really, really enjoying this arc and this season. And you called it a couple, I don't know, this was like a couple years ago maybe. We were talking about the episode where Venus is going on two dates, which, you know, if you're going to do that, if you're going to do that, can you please make sure there are two guys that might not want to kill you? Just something to keep in mind. But that episode was so much fun. And I really, she's running back and forth between the two dates, and there's this huge like running montage. And I remember the director said, "Well, break this up because this is a lot of hyperventilating, and I don't want you to pass out, and you're gonna have to vary up the efforts." And I was like, "No, I want to do it all at once." So we did like an entire 30 to 60 seconds of hyperventilating at different paces, and I was like, "Oh, I'm fine." The last three efforts, I started getting really dizzy and everything went black and she was like, that was great. And I was like, okay, I need like 5 seconds to figure out where I am. But that was so much fun. I love that episode. But there've been a lot of really fun episodes with this arc. But I remember that one time I almost passed out in the booth was great.
Did Venus find like the evil guys on Tinder or like what is?
You know what, I don't know. There's gotta be like an app, you know, evil villain app, because I feel like that's where she's finding the majority
very
of her
niche
options.
Dating.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Check it out.
I think I'm still a baby.
You're still a baby.
You're still a baby.
Still
a baby, so. But Uranus and Neptune show up in the specials.
Can we talk about that?
Yeah.
Oh, we're talking about that. Sweet.
So awesome. Basically, my only choice is my favorite part is when I was sick in bed. And Neptune nursed me back to health.
So sweet.
But also, I was flirting with the nurse and she got jealous and threatened me.
Yeah, that's pretty great.
But that's my favorite.
Don't mess with my girl.
Season.
That's also really, that's a really good episode. My other favorite episode is the Venus one where she goes on the double date. I think it's absolutely hilarious. This season I think is a lot more upbeat than the last season. So I think it's always been one of my favorite seasons, so it's very pretty. I think it's even more sparkly. I don't know why, it just seems...
It just happens, glitter gets everywhere.
Right? I think it's because there's a literal Pegasus in the season, so that probably has something to do with it. But
I,
the special...
I get it everywhere, I'm sorry. But to be fair, the Amazon trio, they are equally sparkly. Have you seen them?
They
like,
really
my God.
Are. And they're Amazing. Also a couple of my favorite villains, actually.
Me too.
In the entire series. So.
I got to say, on the note of earlier about new cast members, John, Eric, and Michael are awesome. I've heard a little bit of them. The Amazon trio are spectacular. You're going to really like their performances in the season. So shout-outs to them and stuff.
Yeah. Now we have another. I know this isn't about the content of the season, but you guys have been growing as characters, growing with your characters. What advice would you give the character you play?
Cherami has an answer, clearly.
Will you repeat that question?
Yes. What advice would you give the character you play?
I would tell Mike. Can I go?
Yeah, of course. You're the smart one, after all.
I like that I'm really smart and stuff, but I'm always telling people they need to study, and I think maybe I need to, you know, just chill out a little bit. That's what I would say. Just, like, let people kind of, you know, maybe not everybody wants to be a brain and go off to college and blah, 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 you know?
Yeah, live a little. Enjoy
live
your teenagers.
Live a little. I would tell my character to let people live.
That sounds like a really fun, like, I don't know, not rom-com, but like those like movie nights or like, you know, those movies where it's like, let loose for one night. And it's like Mercury yeah. lets loose and like burns down the house.
See,
and it's
and
like,
that's what I'm saying. Someone needs to like put something in my drink.
Yeah.
No.
We should.
No.
I would tell Chibi Yusa to stay true to your heart and stay away from that older boy that wants to date you. That creepy older boy in that one season. I mean, that one episode, he's like tall.
Oh, the one with the underpants?
Yeah, yeah, that one.
Yeah,
scary.
No means no.
Super
scary.
That's
better than no underpants.
And he's much older.
I would tell Usagi that she looks great, so she can eat as much as she wants. And that she doesn't have to stress out about studying so much because she's gonna save the world anyway.
I guess I would tell Mako, I would tell her that the guys that she's chasing after, like, you shouldn't have to chase somebody that hard. Like, they're not, you know, you deserve somebody who chases you back. So, and also maybe if she wants somebody who, like, isn't intimidated by strong girls, maybe, like, scope out a CrossFit or something. I don't know. No, like, go into a CrossFit and be like, okay, these are my dudes, maybe. I don't know. Just a thought.
I would tell Venus that even though she's the guardian of love, she doesn't need to find love in a man in order to be the guardian of love. She already is. So stop like saying, like, I need a boyfriend, I need to find a boyfriend, and being obsessed with that. Just love yourself, love the girls and the people you're around, and just be love. It's fine. Because, like, the whole trying to find love in a guy situation, like I said, she went on two dates at once, and they ended up really not responding well to being cheated on in the same day.
I don't blame them.
So that's, well, no, but also, even the guys that she loves, when she's dating one at a time, it hasn't worked out, so it's not the time or place right now.
She's
it will
also
happen.
14.
I understand that.
I say more power
that.
To her.
Do what?
I say more power to her.
Yeah, I agree. Time and place. It'll happen when it's
I
fun.
Think what Kate means is... why limit
time.
Yourself to two people?
Right.
At,
why not?
At
why?
If she almost passed out running between the two, pick closer locations if you're gonna do that. But she can't fit another guy in that day.
She needs Mercury's. She needs to be smarter about
I'm
it.
I'm gathering that Mercury apparently has the dirtiest mind of any of the Sailor Guardians.
Who knew?
Cristina, could you tell Mars anything?
I would say, like, she never, like, when she, before she died, spoiler, she was like, I should have kissed you, Ichiro, but she hasn't yet.
Wait, she came back to life and never did it.
Yeah, I would say, like, girl, what are you doing?
That's it.
I feel like Uranus would be giving me advice. So I have nothing.
I would actually probably tell both Neptune and Uranus that even though they're concerned about the world ending, it's okay to trust people. Because I honestly think they have major trust issues when it comes to not knowing the other guardians. So I think, and I think that's a general note for everybody. I mean, you want to be careful, but it's okay to let people in. It's not an awful thing. So that's my take on it. Thank you.
I think my advice would be therapy. She's just got a lot going on inside, if you know what I mean. And she's got some dad issues and a bunch of stuff she's got to work out. And she should talk to somebody about it. Right? Yeah.
Okay. I have a quick story.
What?
About Christine.
What?
So we were watching Sailor Moon S. And we're watching like all her Hotaru scenes, how she gets like really sick all the time. She's always getting hurt. So Christine leaves, and then she falls and like twists her ankle. And she was like, Cristina! And I went, Hotaru-chan.
I was leaving her house. It was like midnight. I fell off the driveway into the street. I dropped my Sailor Moon DVDs into the street, and I couldn't get up. And I was like, crying on the floor and trying to figure out, like, do I yell for help? Do I crawl back inside? What do I do?
I carried her inside.
Yeah, and then it was twisted for a month.
You really are a guardian.
It's so sweet. It was rough. Yes.
Why is the image of you crying in a pool of Sailor Moon DVDs so funny to me? I'm sorry. Tragedy plus time equals comedy. That's so funny.
If it didn't happen to me, I would have laughed.
So funny.
What I love is how everybody was like, oh, when she said, oh, I tripped. And then as soon as she mentioned the Sailor Moon DVDs, it was like, no.
You guys care more about that than me.
You didn't scratch them, did you?
Where did Robbie get the tragedy plus time equals comedy
for
you?
That's classic. It's true.
By the way,
I need that phrase on a t-shirt. It's totally a wear it all the time.
Totally a
saying. Make it happen, Robbie.
Not original. Not. Do you have advice for your horseman?
Wow.
And I don't know his part that very well.
And talking about trust.
Hey, your carrots.
They're not even, sugar cubes are my thing, thank
sugar
you.
Sugar cubes.
Well, Lauren was talking about trust. Interestingly, trust is actually a theme that I feel really strongly about in, especially kids' stories. And with Pegasus slash Helios, because he was hurt, not to go too much into spoiler territory, but he was hurt, and you know, therefore that informs his reason to be distrusting, as opposed to like, oh, we have to go find the Holy Grail and we're going to kill everybody. Guys, but in his case, I would actually say, when you're ready, like, don't rush it. Yes, I want you to find someone, which of course he does, that he can trust. But I think that in a case like him, I know, because of what he'd been through, I think that, like, it has to be, like, you have to come to that conclusion. You have to find that person on your own. And when you meet them, you'll know them. And he sure did, so. Yeah.
What a good answer. That's a very good answer. So deep.
What's yours?
Well,
I know your answer.
Going back to the spa episode, I would tell Mamoru to not be so embarrassed of that sweet butt. Did you see that booty in that episode? There's a scene where he runs away from her and jumps in the air, and it's just a straight up butt shot in the middle of the show. And when I was dubbing it, I was like, is this really happening? Can I make a squeaky noise when he jumps in the air and it's his butt shot? That's the only advice I have for him. That's it. Be cool
Wonderful.
With your own body.
That's awesome advice.
He does squats.
Do we have everyone?
Yeah, I think, do we have everyone? We have everyone. All right. So let's take a little break. I know this is. We're moving to the next thing. It's more glitter, more glitter, more glitter. So I think we have something really special here. Yes, I actually going to get out of sleep for a bit. We have a little bit of manga news for you guys today.
Yeah,
you know, Sailor Moon, we're here talking with all of these anime voice actors, but Sailor Moon is based on an original manga by Naoko Takeuchi, and it's celebrating its 25th anniversary this year. So if you go in the dealer's room, you'll see Tokyo Otaku Mode. You can get your membership for the Sailor Moon fan club. But we're also here to talk about new manga editions that are coming out this January, the Eternal Edition. And these are magnificent. They're bigger trim size, beautiful art, and they include color pages. So here's a sample of one of the color pages that you get in the Eternal Edition. This isn't the only one. There's tons more when you buy the book. But joining me today, who better to talk about this beautiful manga? We have a representative from Kodansha to come say hi. So if you could come up and join us. Do we have Naho? She is going to be telling a little bit about our Eternal Editions. So I'll give you my mic. Oh, the microphone from Sailor Moon.
Thank you, Sagi. Hi, I'm Naho from Kodansha Comics. This is my first Moon panel, so I'm a bit intimidated. Hi, everyone. Hi, all fans. We're so excited to announce our Sailor Moon Eternal Edition coming out on January 30th. Like every one of you, I was an anime fan in the beginning. Back in Japan, I was watching anime every Saturday night glued on TV screen. And then I came across this beautiful manga, original works by Naoko Takeuchi. And when I was reading in Nakayoshi magazine, all these beautiful color pages just blew my mind. And now we're so happy to print them in color as a collectible edition. Bigger format, premium paper, with holographic treatment. We're trying to make it glittery as possible, as Charlie's necklace. And my editor in charge would have loved to come and talk about it, but she's up in Canada doing press check right now with a Japanese printer, so we're happy to bring this comic in January. Thank you.
Thank you. You guys are all gonna pre-order it, right? Yeah. Give her a big round of applause. Yay. Oh, I always love to be joined by manga pals. Now, we turn the tables on the cast again. We are going to do our Sailor Guardian Challenge, where we challenge two guardians in a battle of wits or more. So, we've randomly selected two guardians. Let's see who they are. So, this first one is we're going to do a transformation switch between Mars and Uranus. So, first, the Sailor Guardian will demonstrate the proper way to do the transformation. And then you will switch. It'll be a challenge. So we have Cristina and Erica. Are you guys ready? Who wants to go first? Who wants to demonstrate?
I'll go first.
Mars, planet power, make up!
It's Uranus'
turn. Uranus, planet power, make up! Uranus, planet power, make up!
We're actually the same person. So, nice job.
Didn't they do a great job?
Sometimes, not in this show, but on other shows, there's you guys have some overlap. You guys, can sound like each other.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, and if one of us records, efforts first, we always have to do them over.
We do the same effort always. It's crazy.
Very similar instincts.
Okay. The next one is an attack switch. So, we will have Jupiter and Mercury, because you guys have a lot to pick from. So, for Jupiter, it's going to be Supreme Thunder, and for Mercury, it'll be Shine Aqua Illusion. Okay. All right. So, this is a challenge, because she's really cool. And, you know, she's here to destroy things, so good luck. Yeah.
I'm channeling the Mercury here, yes. though, so.
So first, demonstrate Jupiter.
Okay.
Supreme Thunder!
Now, Mercury, demonstrate. Shine.
Or attack.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Do
shine
on mine?
Illusion. Yeah.
Or I supposed to sound like that? I do mine.
Yeah, you do yours first, and okay. then you'll switch.
I believe in you.
I don't know why this is so funny to me. Okay. Okay. Don't look at me. I'm sorry. This is going to take 45 freaking minutes because I'm going to.
We believe in
okay,
you.
Okay, here we go.
Ready?
It's very serious. That's why I'm doing this. Okay. Shine Aqua Illusion! Shine Aqua Illusion!
Now, Supreme Thunder.
She's gonna take my job. Oh. You gotta do it again. I gotta get in my hair.
Supreme Thunder! Supreme Thunder!
Oh, I cracked. Can I have one more shot at that?
Yeah!
I didn't sleep last night.
Take two.
Supreme Thunder! Is that right?
I'll take
Yay!
The
detail. Oh, fabulous. Oh, we are all thoroughly attacked. So, we're going to share the love with you guys. We have time for another prize break. So, let's, ooh, oh wow, we have the lights up. So, we have our three categories, but this prize break, we are just going to do one because we have more for later. So, pick one magical winner. One, you have David. You will get to pick between colors, manga, and music. All right. Which category do you pick?
Colors.
Colors. Oh, okay, so this is actually secretly really tough. What color is Sailor Mercury's front bow? Yeah. Do you know? Scream it out. Who got it? David, who got
light
it?
Light blue?
Yes, it's light blue. Yay! All right, awesome. All right, so we're gonna have more prizes later. We have a couple really big ones left. I'm super excited about it. Yeah, so let's take another little change of pace and let's talk about Sailor Moon Crystal. Yeah, sorry, the screen is blinking a little bit, but the power of love is what counts. So we got our message from our lovely manga pal. So Sailor Moon Crystal is a directed manga reboot of the classic Sailor Moon tale, and we have a bunch of it out now. So this is season one. It has the entire Dark Kingdom arc, and it's like a disco flashing lights with more glitter. It comes with all of the episodes, art cards, a booklet, and so much more. We also have season two, which is the Black Moon Saga. Wow, this connection just wants to like have a little rave here for you guys.
It's the Dead Moon Circus. They're trying to interfere.
Yeah,
with
it's clowns. It always comes back to clowns.
It's the clowns.
Always comes back to clowns. We also have, this is coming December 5th. And what's December 5th, Amanda?
Jupiter's birthday.
Yeah, you can celebrate Jupiter's birthday with Sailor Moon Crystal season
Yay!
Three.
Yay!
You can pre-order this. This has all of the Infinity Death Busters arc. And if you pre-order it from Right Stuff, you get the lovely Suncatcher. Yeah. super duper fanciful. And let's hope this works. We have a trailer to show you. So, fingers crossed this works. So, all right, it stayed stable for a second.
All right. Everybody synchronize your blinking.
Yeah.
I like seeing the Outer Guardians not entirely too different, but they're still a little different.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm pretty different.
Whoa. You are a little bit, yeah. It's the animation is gorgeous. I also think, you know, we get to see more of Uranus and Neptune's personal life as opposed to just a couple dramatic scenes here and there.
Yeah.
So I think that's kind of nice.
And the ending theme.
I'm very excited. I get a cat.
A cat. Yeah.
I have my own cat, so.
I also feel like in Crystal, at least in season three, I feel like we all, not Outer Guardians, the inner Guardians who aren't Sailor Moon get more, I guess, personality.
Yeah.
Like they kind of get a little more goofy and you get to see a little bit more like individuation of them.
I think I mentioned this at another panel and I can't remember if this is the one we were talking about, but we had a huge break. We had not done any Sailor Moon before, and then we came back and started working on Crystal Season 3. So it was just exciting to get back and start doing more Sailor Moon again because I had missed it. And like Amanda said, this has been one of my favorite seasons. It's beautiful, but also I feel like there's more interaction between all of us, not just doing battle scenes. Like you get the slice of life moments where you kind of see how all of us relate to each other, and that's been really fun to get to see where we fit in context with each other, which has been really fun.
It's not that different for me because I never know what's going on. So like coming back to another season, I'm just perpetually confused. And that's why we were talking about having Susie, who's our director, is so great. Like she's like a walking compendium of lore. She just knows everything. So I come in and I look at her with a wide-eyed stare and she goes, "You don't know what's happening, do you?" And I go, "No." And then she says, "Okay, there's a Pegasus man now. And Chibius is old, but she's young. And there's more cats now." And I go, "Uh-huh." And then I'm like, "What's my line?" And then I read a piece of poetry and fly away into the night. But no, seriously, for Crystal, I feel like since it follows the manga closely, it's a lot easier to track the plot. I don't feel like quite as lost as I do in Classic. And I do love the character designs. And I feel like a lot of more, like you were saying, more slice of life, honest moments where the plot kind of chugs along.
Yeah.
It feels a lot more connected than, you know, the weird filler episodes and all this. Even though I love Classic, I really like coming in to do Crystal for that reason. I like a streamlined story. Yeah.
I also just, and this goes for Classic and Crystal, I don't know about you guys, but I really love the episode titles. Like, they are so random, some of them, and they always make me laugh. So that's, like, whenever we open a new episode.
You don't have to say them.
That's true.
Classic
or Crystal. But they're so funny.
It's like, "Mirage, my best friend is a turkey."
Yeah.
My favorite ones are the ones where it's part two. And then there's like two numbers in it.
There was the cat fidelity episode. The title of that was so funny that she goes, "You're not in this episode, so we could skip it." And I'll say, "But I need to figure out what the episode title was just so I can read it, even if Venus is not in the episode, because I love them so much." And that goes for both Classic and Crystal. But you're right, I don't have to read them.
What one has the funny one?
Thank you so much
Crystal
for doing them
Classic justice.
They're extraordinary.
Sometimes I have to take a second take because like there'll be a comma,
or
and
a
then
question
I'll
mark.
Yeah, like I'll read it one way, and then I'm like, "Oh wait, no, that's not where the pause goes," because the title will be so long.
It's awesome.
And I'm not in Crystal.
Yeah.
Yet.
I have a question.
Sure.
Do your characters talk a little differently in?
Mine did. Mine has a completely different voice. We had to try 3-4 times. The client had to come and approve it. We did it again. Because Sailor Saturn has a different voice.
I mean, between Classic and Crystal.
Yeah, between Classic and Crystal.
Yes. Because sometimes so much time lapses, like, between records that the last time, I mean, I was just like, "Can you play my voice, ref?" Because I can't remember, because they're kind of different.
They're, like, just a little bit different. It's
mine is
really subtle.
It's very subtle, but it's real. It's real.
It's real. Like a tonal shift.
Yes.
And
yes.
Then it's a little bit deeper for me. Yep.
My voice is deeper.
Mine, she's Russian in the.
Yeah. Yeah. Mine has a little bit of like a Harvey Fierstein, and then I kind of shifted it a little bit. So.
Great.
You guys are so right. These episode names are fantastic.
What are they? Read us a few.
I have no idea. Hold on, I'll just pick one. Bobby. Dreams take flight. Meeting of destiny. The night Pegasus dances. It's like bad interpretive. Here, you read one. Here, check that. Do that one.
Okay, I'll do my best, Stephanie.
Yeah.
Sweet dreams. Protect mom's dream. Double moon's new attack.
Yes.
Ba 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 ba.
Really long. They're really long, and sometimes there's not enough time.
You do this one, please.
Which one?
This one.
Please.
Right there.
Phony fairy. Wait, see, this is the problem. I don't. Oh, no, is that.
That's all of it.
It's the second one. It's the second one.
The comma there?
Just read them all!
Okay. Phony fairy, forest of illusion, a beautiful fairy's invitation.
It's so good.
I just also love that no matter how ridiculous they are, when you do the next episode preview, it could be like.
And then it ends with. Moonlight is a messenger of
love. In like the most serious way ever after like the incredible blah, blah, blah and something, something. And now also I'm really cool. And I'm like, Stephanie, only you could do this. Only you were this good.
They're good, right?
It's true. Great. I have no idea. I've only come in for the last 2 minutes.
You cannot miss reading an episode title.
Although I feel like sometimes they're huge spoilers. Like the end of season
one.
Tragic sailor guardians die a horrible death.
Exactly, I agree.
Dancing twin dragons, the ending of this
sailor
one's
Moon,
very
now
cool.
With more cats.
And you're like, wait, there's more cats coming, I knew it.
So let's, while technical support is working on things with all the blinking, we're hoping to fix it because we have some really cool things coming. I'm bringing it back to Crystal. So, you know, you guys mentioned that your characters get a little bit different in Sailor Moon Crystal than they are in the 90s series. So, which character do you feel got especially cooler in Sailor Moon Crystal?
I think I got cool.
Yeah, I think Christine's character.
I got, like, robot parts, and then
it's true.
I become a bigger villain than even in Classic. Yep. Like, there was a point where, like, I used the deepest voice I have ever, ever used, and I just yelled for an hour as a, like, a 75-foot demon. Yeah.
Like you do.
Yeah. So it's pretty cool.
Yeah.
I actually thought that Mamoru was getting cooler in Crystal than he was in the original. Well, there's, like, a whole scene between Michiru where she's kind of flirting with Mamoru a little bit. And I just remember also, that's another thing I remember, that she's way more flirty in Crystal than she is in the original. But yeah, I just think that Mamoru is somehow cooler in Crystal than he is in the original. So good job, Robbie. Good job.
Doesn't he have some sort of like intuitive powers in Crystal too? Because there was a point where like stuff is happening and you like sense it. But I don't remember you doing that in Classic.
No, he has powers in Crystal, not just a cane that extends really far.
See what I mean? Yeah. He got cooler.
Yeah,
he got
I'll
cooler.
Save you.
No.
I feel like he gets
cooler. Has, like power of invisibility. Yes. Because we never see him and then boop.
No,
there.
He's just hiding behind a shrub. We've established this.
Or in front of a billboard.
At all times, he's like, dog, it's my chance.
I think you had a cooler car in Crystal. I think your car was cooler.
What's cooler than a school bus?
Don't you have a motorcycle?
I do have a motorcycle. Right. Yeah.
Do you guys have helicopters?
Yes.
Yes.
We have two helicopters.
Two helicopters. Yes.
Yeah. Oh, helicopters.
That's cooler. I mean, I think Uranus definitely got cooler, if I may be biased for a second. She's somehow more gender fluid than she was in the Classic series, which is really cool. Like, I know she cares a lot less about people, saying if she's a boy or a girl. And I think because of that, she ends up being a lot deeper, like, at the beginning. And then when you finally, like, she starts wearing, like, really sexy clothes, and then she gets a little bit more feminine, but still masculine. Like, it's crazy. She's
it was a
cool.
little, it was very new for me personally to see her in feminine clothing. It was very different, because I'm used to seeing her in more tomboyish.
She wears, like, these hot leather numbers. They're pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. It works.
And helicopters, you know.
Well, helicopters are always cool.
I just don't understand why you need two.
One for each of us.
Is it like a Monday, Wednesday, Friday situation?
Yes.
And then Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, and Sunday you take the day off? Like, why do you need two?
Could you
imagine? We have a separate one for
sometimes one helicopter is in the shop. And then you have to use your other helicopter.
Use your head.
Sometimes we get shot out of the sky by, like, angry clowns. I don't know.
It's just cool, Cherami, okay? It's just cool.
I think someone should give Venus a helicopter so she would understand the luxury and be able to understand why she would need seven, one for each day of the week.
You're not old enough.
Could you imagine showing up to an event with the same helicopter as somebody else? How embarrassing that would be?
You're right. You got to do different colors, different levels of sparkle.
Right.
They've got to be ready for the occasion. That's a great point.
You're teachable.
You're so smart, Amanda.
You're teachable.
All right, let's go on. Well, we have one of them is blinking, but the one in the center is stable, and that is good. That is good. So we are in good shape.
Progress.
So, yes, progress. Love and justice together. So one more reminder. So we have our autograph session today at 2. Hopefully we can get this back to the center one. It's like frozen. But yes, 2 o'clock, the autograph area. Bring your poster, Sailor Moon items.
I was gonna say, she
so
was waiting.
We've got one. We are all going to remember this experience.
Wait, what?
Good thing I have a little bit of a backup plan because we still have some really cool announcements. But first, we're going to do our final prize break.
Yay! Woo!
With our lovely Sailor Guardians and David. So this one is going to be crystal themed. So, Super Sailor Moon. We have 2 bags left. So, oh, thank you, Helios. All right. So, maybe Helios and David are going to find a lovely winner. All right, so we're going to do, here is our category. So find someone who has lots of excitement. Right.
I thought I still had fun.
Yeah, because we have 2 categories. We have a cast and music.
I thought I still had manga left.
Yeah.
Oh, sad face. Music.
Yeah, pick music. All right. So, your question is, name one of the theme songs for Sailor Moon Crystal.
Oh, I was just watching this 2 days ago. Moon Bride?
Moon Pride, yes!
Wow.
Yes, you win! All right. Winner, winner. All right, we have our last question. This one is nightmare mode. And
I don't like that.
You don't get a category. I just challenge you. So,
don't get whooped.
Yeah. All right, are you ready for nightmare mode?
Sounds amazing.
Okay, so your
clowns,
question is...
Clowns.
Actually, you know what? I'm not gonna be too nightmare mode. I'm gonna have pity in my heart because you guys have been putting up with our surprise rave here today. Okay. Name the English voice actor for Sailor Mars. She's. She's very close
Christine.
By. Cristina V, yes.
Cristina V, yeah.
Yay, you win.
She's right good. Over there.
We're all about love and adjustments. So now we have, this is a part you guys have been waiting for. We have announcement time. Whoa, that got really loud really quick. So our announcement is Supers themed. And it looks like maybe the blinking stopped. So we have a new cast member. We have Zirconia. Is being played by Janice Carroll. Yeah. And I have a clip of Zirconia that I would love to play. I'm concerned about the blinking, but let's try it. And if it doesn't work, I have a backup plan that I think you guys are going to like. So let's take our first listen to Zirconia and the Amazon Trio. From Supers. Let's hope. So we have another Supers announcement. We have Supers Part 1. It is up for pre-order on Right Stuff right now. It comes out this spring, the very first week of April, and is the first half of Supers. We have a lovely mint green sparkly box as we work our way through the rainbow. This also has a 96-page booklet, and you get the Moon Crisis makeup coin when you order from Right Stuff. So you can pre-order that right now. And the coin is only available while supplies last. So isn't it gorgeous?
It's so pretty.
Yeah. And there might even be a golden crystal inside. I know. All right. So also in this set is something really special we alluded to before. You will get the Supers TV specials, which have never, ever been released. As Lauren and Erica mentioned, these have an episode with Uranus and Neptune in it. And Neptune actually has a really, really cool scene. And I am happy to show you, I have a clip from the Supers specials with Neptune being quite a badass. I saw this and I was like, oh man, I wanted to pick one clip and I just couldn't because this is just amazing. So,
I'm so excited.
Let's see a little outerly amazing. Wow. And tonight after the autograph session, it's 7 o'clock in panel 3, you're gonna get to see the first 3 episodes of Supers. So all of that Amazon Trio action, everyone is welcome to come, but offer not valid for the dead moon. Bring your beautiful dreams, but it's a safe space. No one will be taking your beautiful dreams. So we just have a couple more Supers related questions. And you know that scene reminded me, so this is actually for Erica. You're doing some script adaptation for this season, so
yeah.
You get to put words in the Guardians' mouths.
Yeah.
What's that been like?
It's been crazy. I actually wrote the movie that we just watched, so that was fun. Yeah, it's just kind of something that I've been doing lately, and it's been cool to kind of, you know, especially work on Sailor Moon just because it's, you know, I'm already a Guardian, so it's cool to be part of that legacy, but getting to put, like, you know, words into everybody's mouths and, like, learn more about the characters than I feel like I did before is really cool. So it's been really fun.
Yeah, and that's good. And Supers is so good. It was so hard, really, to pick clips for this panel because I watched them in the background as I'm working and I'm just laughing to the point where I guess I became a distraction for laughing so much because it's all so great. You're doing a fabulous job. So I can't wait for it to come out and everyone to get to see all your writing goodness.
Yeah, thanks.
Now we have a couple more fun questions. This is for everyone. Because Sailor Moon has her team of 4 Guardians. If you could pick 4 Sailor Guardians for your personal team, who would you pick?
I just had a flashback to middle school. This isn't fair.
Yeah.
I know, right?
Red this Rover, Red hard. Rover.
This is basically who are you going to leave out?
Who's, yeah. Yeah. Who gets to sit at your lunch table and who has to eat alone?
Moon, Chibi Moon, Jupiter, Venus. There you go.
Wow, he had no problem.
Well, you have to pick your girlfriend.
Same feeling.
I would, no offense to any of you guys, but I would pick all the outers. Because like,
I knew you were my favorite.
I'm just saying, like, the power to stop, like control time, destroy planets, shake worlds, and like tsunamis. Like, I feel like I'm in, like, and also, they don't give a crap. They'll do what needs to be done. They'll kill whoever needs to be killed.
They might not listen
and
to you.
I don't have to get my hands dirty.
Pluto might be like, hey now, maybe don't kill that person.
Or
but.
She, no, Pluto like totally was like, wasn't she like, I'm gonna kill you? And you were like, she's like,
but
oh,
what if
sorry.
You get like baby oh, sorry. Saturn?
Oh, I don't want baby Saturn.
Baby you get me Saturn. As a baby? Yeah.
No, can I have her as Mistress Nine?
Why not?
That's not a Guardian.
That's not a good thing.
Oh, yeah, she wouldn't really be controllable, I guess.
It's all about control.
Anyone else want to throw in?
I don't want to get beat up.
I know, this makes me really sad. Okay, I don't want to get beat up, so I'm going to pick the, it's not really a diplomatic answer. I pick all the cats. It's just
so not fair,
it's just me and cats.
Wait, then you have one more position. One
it's
more.
Okay. The cats are powerful enough. We'll just have 3.
They can have a second kid later.
What about the cat yes. lady? The cat what? Lady. The lady that had all the cats in her
yeah.
house.
I actually just made Venus like single forever with all the cats. Like, I didn't mean to do that. I just
That's
didn't want
perfect.
To hurt any feelings, so I'm just picking cats.
I feel
would pick
you.
Any all the people that nobody else wants. But none of the cats.
That's okay. I'll take that.
Because I don't like cats. I'm sorry. I bet now a lot of people probably are mad at me. I just don't like them.
It's okay. You're a guardian of water, so it works out.
I want an army of Mamoru, so I'd like choose street clothes Mamoru, tuxedo mask, Moonlight Night, and Endymion.
You stole my answer, because I was going to say Sailor Mars, Sailor Mars, Sailor Mars, and Sailor Mars, just in quadruplicate. We didn't say what this team was for, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
So Robbie's team is lit.
Yeah. is street clothes Mamoru purple sweater pleated pants Mamoru? Or is that
no?
Is that one is one on its own?
I want like the running clothes with like the rolled
yes.
sleeves.
Yes. Oh, good.
The windbreaker option.
I think I'll go with my original like favorite four, which is Mars, Jupiter, Uranus, and Neptune.
It's a powerful team.
Nobody has picked me. I just want you to know that.
You can join my. Oh, you don't like the cats. Never mind.
Yeah, you don't like cats.
Mine's his boys only.
It's gonna be me and the cats.
But it's gonna be me.
Can I pick?
Yeah. Sailor Mommy, and your two helicopter pilots.
Yeah.
So, good team.
Sailor helicopter pilot.
You just want to ride down to like Jamaica. That's it.
Not just for the helicopter, because clearly they have NDAs, right?
Yes, yeah. Of course.
It makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
Who do you want, Stephanie?
I think it'd actually be Mercury, Jupiter, Pluto, and then I can't decide on the last one. I can't. That's hard.
No, don't pick him. He picked all
him.
Mars.
Don't,
he didn't pick you.
That's true.
He didn't pick me. I
he
know.
Didn't pick you. Don't.
I know. But I don't think he just like he'd always be late. You know, he like wouldn't really show
he's not
up.
A team
it just
player.
Like, feel like
he's
wouldn't
not a team
be
player.
Consistent. And like I'm still butt sore over Uranus and Neptune not like getting with the program for an entire season. So
you know what? Can I tell you something? Me too. The entire season, I'm like, come on, team up. The faster you team up, the quicker you can defeat the bad guys. It works that
and
much simpler.
And as powerful as Saturn is, she's just like unpredictable.
Like a teenager.
I can't argue
like
that.
A teenager.
Yeah.
She's the loose cannon. Like in the police show, they're like, come on, Gonzalez, you're a loose cannon. Stop destroying worlds.
I'm the wild card.
Tomoe, whatever.
We can go to therapy together.
Yeah. No, I'm changing
we'll
my answer.
We'll work it out.
The Amazon Trio and Pegasus, just those four. Does that count? Does that work? I'm good? Okay, I'm good.
All right, so we have one more. This one is really cheesy, but with the theme of supers for everyone, can you tell us what your beautiful dream is?
I already said it. Sailor Mars, Sailor Mars. Sailor Mars, and Sailor Mars.
They just peer into your mirror and they're like, oh my God, wow.
I want to live in London one day and have little children that talk like this and be like, Mummy, can you take
can
me to
have some tea?
Yeah, give me some tea and you can take me to American football practice. Because if you say football, you're talking about soccer.
No,
you barbarian.
I just think it's hilarious.
They have to call it, they have to differentiate
it. But the
it.
Accent sort of dropped when you said American.
American.
So it was like, American football practice. like you hated saying the word.
Yes.
Your British children did anyway.
They do. They don't like it.
What's your beautiful dream, guys?
They don't like it.
I want to pet all the cats in the world.
Yes.
Hang on to my team.
Yes. I feel like... Like, this question, just thinking about it makes me want to cry.
I know,
me too!
Like,
I can't handle it. I don't know. I just want to be friends with everybody and, like, have people over and play board games and switch. And, like, I want that to be my life. Just work and then come home and hang out with people and just be happy. Did somebody say, and pizza?
Pizza, yeah.
That's important.
Yeah, we could have pizza, too.
All of those things plus pizza.
That's implied. I thought in everybody's dream was pizza.
I'd like a cure for all allergies.
So me and Cherami Amen. Can eat food again.
Yes.
Oh, God. I miss it.
A cure for all allergies. That's so sweet.
Everybody. I think mine's the typical Miss America. I just want peace in the world. I want to see peace in the world and everybody happy and everybody included and just, you know, getting along. That's it.
Oh, I agree. My actual beautiful dream, it's the opposite. It's total robot Armageddon.
What? It's coming.
Everyone's dead.
It's
just
coming.
Me and a ragtag band of warriors.
Sophia.
That's my real
Robbie's not allowed to
the
have his dream.
Are coming.
Yeah.
Yeah,
Robbie,
right?
Well, like, you can make a movie of your dream and then unhave that dream.
Right,
yes.
Don't have it.
Okay?
It's already there. He made Minority
he has,
Report,
like, the pure
Blade
black
Runner.
We'll make a movie and get it out of your system.
Did you hear that joke that they always said about Tim Burton where they were like, they let Tim Burton make movies because they're afraid of what he would do if he wasn't making movies.
That's hilarious.
That's good.
I don't know. I don't remember who said that. It's not mine. But
you know, on the note of creating stuff, I'm living my beautiful dream. I'm making a video game.
Oh, yeah.
And your Pegasus.
That was a beautiful dream. I really, really wanted to be part of this, and it is a dream come true, so I am very, very grateful for that. But
I think my dream is kind of along the lines of what Cristina was talking about. I just want to be friends with everybody and just have a wonderful time with everybody that is in my life and spread positivity. You know, I just think life's too short to waste it on being negative. And I think, you know, that's just my goal in life, is to try and be positive towards everyone and everything and just enjoy our time together. That's what I really want. And, you know, and to be able to, you know, live out my dream as I'm doing with what I'm doing and just go home with, hang out with fun people and have pizza. So.
Did you have a beautiful dream?
New York pizza.
The only pizza.
New York pizza.
All the pizza.
I always loved being in this industry, and that's all I wanted to do ever since I was a kid, in whatever facet that was. And so I feel like I've been very fortunate to have worked in this industry for over 20 years, and I want to keep doing things that I have not done. I want to make films that make people happy and expose people to different lifestyles and stories that they might not get to experience in their normal existence, and that's one of the reasons why I love being an actor, to try to create a more tolerant, aware, loving, accepting society. And then I would also just like to have a house and a family and get to go do my work and create things that make the world a happier, better place, and then go home to my family and hang out with my friends and just live
and
in my
cats.
Little... And my cats.
And eat pizza.
And make, because Cristina has cured allergies. Cristina's cured allergies, so yes, I will be able to eat pizza with my cats and my family and my friends. So.
What about you, Kate?
No.
Do you have a beautiful dream?
Kate, I want to know what your beautiful dream is.
No, you don't. might include you. No, my dream, what? I just carry the weight of the world on my shoulders, don't I? Because every question, I'm just like, oh, this is serious. Everyone else is so funny. Okay, my dream is that my dog would live forever. Because I love my dog. She's the best dog in the world. And my dream is that my children, I have two boys. My dream is that my children would grow up to know they're loved and know their value as a human, and that's my dream for all children. And I dream that my butt would be a little higher and tighter. And that is a dream, because I ain't doing crap to make it happen.
Make it a reality.
It's it. It's you,
good.
You got to finish it.
I have to finish it.
Yeah.
Well, the easy answer is that my beautiful dream would be that everybody gets their beautiful dreams. But I think really it's that to live in a world where everybody has equal opportunity and feels safe and loved and secure. And I don't really feel like that's a battle right now. And it's okay.
I feel like I'm personally fighting that battle, but I also feel like I look out and I see everybody else doing that too. Whether it be like my friends in the industry, strangers, you know, fans on Twitter, I see everybody like fighting the good fight to create that world. So I want to say thank you and to continue doing that.
Fight!
Aww, all these dreams are so beautiful. Thank you for sharing your beautiful dreams with us. Aw, weren't they beautiful, guys?
Yeah. Wait, Char, what's your beautiful dream?
Oh, well, I'm living it. I mean, it's not blinking anymore.
Short-term beautiful dream. Short-term beautiful dream.
It's very short-term.
Dreams can come true.
I'm just like, I'm a very, contrary to popular belief, I'm a very simple girl. I just want the screen to not blink. The blinking, just up here.
You're wearing a crown. You can't be wearing a crown and be like, I'm a simple girl. Who likes simple things?
I want the pizza and the cats, and you know, and all the rhinestones, of course.
And more Sailor Moon.
Your lashes look great.
They really do.
Yeah. I know. So if you guys ever get hot, I can just like fan you.
Yeah. You look beautiful.
Okay. Oh, thank you. Anything for you guys. Well, we have. So you guys got to hear the Amazon Trio a little earlier, and I just knew that one of these cast members would mention another scene in Supers. And I have one more clip of Supers to show you. It will not be in one of the episodes tonight because it's a little further in the season. So we have to ask no recording of this part because it's a little bit of an initial mix. But it is really, really golden, like golden crystal golden. And we're super happy to share this other clip of the Amazon Trio, which... they're kind of my favorite now, I agree with Chris. So, do you guys want to see it? Set coming up.
That is one of my favorite episodes.
Johnny already lives by that motto of just meow and walk away.
Yes. Yeah, if you ever meet Johnny Youngbosch and you ask him about Artemis, he'll just start meowing.
Yep.
It is great. So, unfortunately, I got it. We are running out of time. So sad, so sad. So unfortunately, we don't have time for questions for the audience right now, but you'll be able to meet the cast at the autograph session. You will be able to see the first episodes of Supers here tonight. So we were going to show it in the panel, but unfortunately, we are out of time. So thank you guys, thanks to all the cast for coming.
Thanks for coming, everybody.
Thank you guys so much. Thank you for being so patient. Thank you for coming to the moon panel. Line up orderly so you can get your treats from the cosplayers. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.